video. Some of these might be repeated from other videos, but it's okay. I also have different life hacks for you guys. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, and if you're not subscribed, then subscribe down below. And yeah, let's just get on with the video.
If you want to make your own DIY lip stain, then you'll just need your own blush and chapstick. So you're going to pick your blush of your choice, and you're just going to rub that all over your lips until they're all covered. Then you're just going to go in with a chapstick, and then you're just going to rub that all over your lips, and there you go. You have a lip stain that will last you all day. To brush your hair properly, you're going to want to start by brushing your hair from the bottom up. This will decrease the amount of knots you have in your hair, and it'll also decrease the amount of breakage and split ends you have in your hair. If you run out of dry shampoo, just replace it with some baby powder and then just rub that all over the top of your head or wherever it's greasy, and then that will just act as dry shampoo and absorb all the grease. To cover up your blemishes properly, you're going to want to obviously put the concealer on top of your blemishes, but instead of rubbing out all the concealer that is on your blemish, you're going to want to pat it on your face instead of rubbing it out, and this will help conceal it better. If you run out of eyebrow mousse, or if you just are in desperate need of combing your eyebrows, just take a almost empty bottle of mascara and use the comb to brush it out. This will help fill in your eyebrows, make it look natural, and also comb them into shape. And once the mascara dries, it'll help your eyebrows stay in place. This is more of an organization tip, but whenever you're in desperate need of a hair tie, always keep them around your brush so you absolutely know where your hair ties are. And let's say you're running late for some reason, then whenever you need a hair tie, you'll always know where they are. Never apply deodorant before you put on your shirt, or also leave white marks on your shirt if it is that type of deodorant. So always apply it after you put on your shirt. If your lips are really dry, then just take a toothbrush and rub it all over your lips. It can be the one you normally even use to brush your teeth because it's all the same, you're part of the same body. So just rub it all over your lips to get all the dryness off, and then go back over on your lips with a chapstick so everything's smooth. So if you want your perfume to stay longer, just take Vaseline and rub it on the spots where you're going to put your let's say fragrance, and then just spray it on there and rub it in, and it will stay for the whole day. If your mascara smeared because you sneezed or something, I got your back. So just take your Vaseline again and then just apply it under your eyes and just rub off all that mascara that's under your eyes, and believe me, it comes right off. Since that I didn't really have that much mascara under my eyes, I'm going to show you with the other side because you'll be able to see a difference better. So then just do the same step on both eyes, and voila, you'll have no mascara under your eyes anymore, and it's so easy. If you want your lipstick to stay all day, all you're gonna do is put it on your lips, and then you're going to take a tissue, as you'll see in a couple seconds, and then you're going to also take any makeup brush, most likely a bigger one, with a little bit of powder on it. Rub that all over your lips, as it shows right here, it's kind of hard to explain. And then take off the napkin and apply more lipstick, and then it will stay on the whole day. If you ever get lipstick on your teeth, and it happens to stain your teeth actually, so just follow this simple step and that will never happen. So what you're going to do is stick your thumb in your mouth or any finger of your choice and just apply the lipstick all around your face. And it's okay to get it on your thumb because it'll just be on your thumb and you won't get any on your teeth. To make sure you don't get any nail polish around your finger, you're just going to want to apply, once again, Vaseline all around your finger before you apply any nail polish to your finger. So now you're going to paint your fingernail, and feel free to get paint on your actual finger because it will just rub off shortly when we take off the Vaseline. So make sure you don't take off the Vaseline while you're painting your nail. So what you're going to do now is rub off all the nail polish that is around your finger, and this will also take off all the nail polish plus the Vaseline, and it will leave you with a clean fingernail. Let's say you have a really bad eyeliner and it's just not working as well as you thought. Well, now all you're gonna do is just blow dry your eyeliner for a couple of seconds, and this will really make the color pigmented and it will just make the eyeliner stick work way better than it did before. So do you just have makeup removers that are really dry? Well, don't throw them out. All you need is a cup of water. So just dunk the makeup remover inside the water and then just squeeze out all the excess water until it's damp. Then now you can use it to remove all of the makeup that is anywhere. I just put all these samples on my arm and voila, it takes up all the makeup instantly, and all you need to do is just add water. I hope you guys enjoyed that video. If you did, give it a thumbs up and subscribe down below if you're not subscribed already. These are inspirations that you can do, and they honestly helped me so much. So I hope they help you guys too. And yeah, so I hope you guys enjoyed that video, and I'll talk to you guys later. Bye!
Finally!
If you can also recreate it, you can't recreate any of these. What am I talking about?
Thumbsing? Is that a word?
Okay, whatever, never mind. If you thumb this video,
get it together.
Oh, and I repeated myself so much. Mm-hmm.